Hello, this is Kevin Bacon again, and that is one bare naked tractor. You see, the shaft that comes from the steering wheel down to this first universal joint here rusted up over the last several years to the point where I couldn't steer it anymore. So I take it apart, and the pin that holds it together happens to be smack dab underneath the gas tank. So, I ended up taking the gas tank off. One of the big reasons I took the gas tank off had nothing to do with not being able to get at that. It had more to do with, and it was a good idea, but it had more to do with what I did to the gas tank while trying to remove this pin. So you say, well, Kevin Bacon, what did you do? Well, here it is. Boom, I punched a hole in the gas tank. It's a pretty little hole. And now I'm going to show you how to fix one of these holes. Very simple. Let's do it. First thing you need to do is find a suitable sheet metal screw that will fit nicely into the hole and screw it in and make sure that it will draw down. If it goes down and just keeps spinning, get a bigger screw because the vast majority of this repair is going to be made by this screw. Okay? After you're sure that this screw will screw into the gas tank and draw down, the next thing is to remove the screw about halfway and let it set. You'll see why in a minute.
Well, my number four video in this track seemed not to come out on the camera, so I'll tell you what I did. I mixed a suitable gasoline resistant epoxy. This one happened to be JB Weld. I've used several other brands and they work just fine as long as they're listed for gasoline and oil resistant. Otherwise the gasoline will eat them. And then after you mix a small amount, you smear it on the threads of that screw so that as you screw it in, it mushes out around the screw. We don't really care to have it go inside the gas tank. We really just need the seal on the outside of the gas tank. So without further ado, we'll get on to the rest of the video.
Okay, now all that remains is to snug that screw down. And as it snugs down, you should see that stuff squish out in all directions. It's not necessary to tighten it down as though it's going to hold a bumper on, because all it's doing is holding the fuel back. Then, after you get the screw tight screwed down, I'm going to use my finger here, but I'm just going to smear this stuff all over and around the head of that screw to make sure we have a nice, even, tight fit. And there you go. We'll let the epoxy cure, and the fuel tank is repaired. Anyway, that's it for now. I'll show you a picture maybe when I get the tractor put back together. Kevin Bacon. Bye for now. Well, there's a lot of hours, but this back together looks a lot more like a tractor now. Yay! Let's see if it'll run. All right, that's what I'm talking about. Allis is running and steering and ready to go. Kevin Bacon. Bye for now. See you tonight. Roundthecabin.com. 8 o'clock Eastern, 7 o'clock Central. Bye. How about road gear? Now the question is, will your tractor run that low RPMs and keep right on puttering along? Mine will.